KC Thompson has been dealing with an injured thumb on his throwing hand. He has struggled not only with health, but also with performance. You can see, you know, we say that, Mark, and look at his conference ranks. He's top five in some pretty notable categories, passing touchdowns, yards per completion, yards as well. So what's been the problem?
Well, the points have added up. It just hasn't been at the right times. The late charge or early and then falling apart defensively. But as you said, it's going to be who is upright and out there today to operate this Texas offense.
Well, right away, they get into the hands of their best playmaker, Xavier Worthy, the conference's leading receiver, who is pushed back and dropped. And Reggie Stubblefield, who is questionable for this game. He was injured late last week against Baylor. It's a loss of one. Stubblefield, the native Texan, born in Lubbock, makes the tackle as they go to the ground of Roshan Johnson, who is taken over as the lead back with Bijan Robinson out for the season with an elbow injury.
As we talked about, second in the Big 12 in scoring, led by senior Derek Kerstetter. Got a great ovation here on his senior day. And then it's all about Xavier Worthy. That first play by design, good. And then where can we get production? Is it Roshan Johnson? Is it Marcus Washington? A lot of drops by the rest of that supporting cast.
So it's a third and three now for Thompson.
K-State will line like this, trying to not give any tolls with their back end. Three-man front, a 3-3-5 by design.
Back in Worthy's hands. Worthy sprints for a first down before being pushed out of bounds by T.J. Smith. His second touch already on this opening drive.
And that's big. They got to be creative in how they do it. They motion him a couple times, motion somebody out to get in front of him. Just watch Cade Brewer, Marcus Washington, who's talked about him. Nice job on the perimeter. Blocking first down, Horns.
That's a gain of 13. He injured today, 84 yards shy of a 1,000-yard season. He simply put up the best freshman campaign by any receiver in Longhorns program history. Thompson completes past the 40. The third catch by Xavier Worthy as Julius Brents brings him down. They move the chains again.
Pretty good, right? 3 out of 4 plays, get it to your guy. Hard sell, play action pass, working the counter, creating a bunch of space between the line of scrimmage and Worthy. Nice execution.
Pick up 17 that time. Worthy gets a breather. Well, we know that Texas was planning on going to the Wildcat often today. They do so right away to Roshan Johnson. Running back takes the snap and handles it himself. How about the defense for K-State?
A little chunk there out of their first Wildcat play. Defensively starts up front with Felix Anudike Uzama leading the world in sacks, TFLs. They get Spencer Trussell back in there, Cody Fletcher, Daniel Green, and then one notable addition here, Wayne Jones out, Ryan Hennington in. Wayne Jones entered the transfer protocol this week and lost Elderall. Unbelievable game last week.
Johnson finds the corner, gets a first down as this Longhorns offense, which has struggled to move the chains. They didn't pick up a first down until the third quarter last week against West Virginia.
Yeah, this is more like the first three quarters of the season for this Texas offense. Off to a fast start. Off to a fast start. See if they can maintain that throughout. So far, so good in terms of getting Roshan Johnson the ball and Xavier Worthy in space.
That's another chunk play. This one good for 12. Worthy's already had multiple receptions of over 10 yards. They go Johnson in the Wildcat once again. Flip to Keelan Robinson. He gets crunched hard to 20. Robinson, the Alabama transfer, was with Sark there.
That'll be a passing, I think, before a loss. So Roshan Johnson's first throw of the game. They got numbers there front side, just a better job that time. Julius Brents, we've seen him before, 6'4", 204, physically getting his guy to the ground.
I'm going to keep Johnson in the Wildcat.
K-State wants to talk about it, I think.
Steve Sarkisian told us that this would be something that they would go to.
Texas, their first of the half.
And then maybe you see it coming out this often, this early. But an early trend for the Longhorns offense moving the sticks. Fox College Football is sponsored by AT&T Business, keeping your business connected with AT&T 5G. And by Progressive Insurance, save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance. Boy, take you back to the first Thanksgiving game.
How about that ball?
Longhorn history, 1893. Now, they're built a little differently these days. Steve Sarkisian, first year as the Longhorns head coach. Six-game losing streak, the longest since 1956. And my goodness, has Sark become embattled this year? He's had to deal with just about everything, both on the field and off. Johnson with a good run right up the middle. It runs into the safety, T.J. Smith. It's good for 6 yards.
That was the same run play that they threw the play-action pass off, and that signed the guard, Imade, 67. Absolutely crushing blow to set up third and manageable. Another Wildcat situation for us here. So instead of rotating it out between Hudson and Carr, Casey Thompson trying to get somebody healthy, they're just going to get Rich on the ball.
He keeps it himself inside the 10. Picks up first and goal, tackled by Daniel Green, one of the great linebackers for the Wildcats.
So what this means is you can just practice all this stuff with the back, the guy you want with the ball, fake it to Robinson, get it to your downhill guy, Roshan Johnson, and it doesn't matter who the quarterback is. You know, substituting those guys in and out during the week, a better way for them to practice during the week.
Hey, this is a curveball. There's no question for Joe Klannerman, DC for K-State. How hard is this to defend?
Texas has done this a little bit, so they absolutely had a plan.
Skipping into the end zone, Roshan Johnson calls his own name, and the Wildcat has paid great dividends this opening drive for the Longhorns.
But there's that old Mike Tyson line, right? Everybody has a plan until you get punched, and right now that run game punched him in the face, getting the ball in the perimeter, and then watch Roshan here. A little look off, and then a little right foot in the ground, untouched. And a highlight shot on Marvin Martin here, making a miss, but a great job up front. That senior late in offensive line. Great start for the Longhorns.
I could not have drawn it up any better, the opening drive for Texas. And a flag is down.
Offside. Defense, number 23, line up in the neutral zone. The penalty's declined. Point after is good.
Roshan Johnson with 6 carries for 44 yards on the opening drive. Plus the stick in the ground and 6 for the Longhorns on the board first. There was Heisman talk surrounding Bijan Robinson earlier this season. He's had just a tremendous year. Unfortunately, lost for the season. You can see the brace on his left elbow. It dislocated that and is out for the season. But his replacement, Roshan Johnson, was the star of the opening drive of the game. 9-yard touchdown run. Overall, 6 carries for 44 yards. But a big loss for Texas. But fortunately for them, they do have some speed in that backfield nonetheless. But a guy you cannot replace in Bijan. Knowles, third of the nation, at over 32 yards in return, dropped just shy of the 40s, taking 2 to the house already this season. And Dicker, on senior day, is in there. Dicker the kicker, one of the most beloved kickers who's seemingly been around forever.
Became Dicker the tackler right there and had right. to. I am shocked they're kicking the ball to Malik Knowles. Both he and Phillip Brooks have the ability to take it to the house. And our answer at quarterback is Will Howard.
And Skylar Thompson, the 6-year senior, injured his ankle late last week. So Will Howard makes his 3rd start of the year, his 10th career start. He started 7 games last year when Thompson was injured.
Big physical dude, 6'4", 235. Anticipate a ton of quarterback run action with him in there.
I want to get him involved. Without question, Andrews Vaughn. Dropped quickly. 4 straight 100-yard games for Vaughn, one of the most versatile backs in the country.
Big play there by Jade Barron coming out of the back end, involving himself in the rush. Noah Johnson, a center, tremendous player, one of their super, super 6 seniors that led them and really led the turnaround this year. On the back end, we saw Malik Knowles. We see Phillip Brooks get involved, but Deuce Vaughn is the star of the show.
He's 5th in the nation in scrimmage yards per game. He's a native of Round Rock, Texas, just a couple of miles north from Austin. He steps up. He barely gets past the line of scrimmage. Keandre Coburn, the nose tackle, brings him out. Now Coburn is down and slow to get up.
Junior from Spring Westfield, Alana. That is a big dude, 6'2", 350, redirecting to tackle Howard. They know the physicality they have to get to Deuce Vaughn and also redirect to get Howard on the ground from behind. Great effort. Hopefully he'll bounce up.
It's a big man at 6'2", nearly 350.
This defense, a ton of questions to begin with. Obviously, throughout the year, have struggled in a big, big way. Today, they're going to be without both inside linebackers. DeMarvion Overshown walked out in senior day and in street clothes effectively this week. Luke Brockermeyer hurt in practice. Just another gut punch to an already beleaguered defense.
Yes, their top two leading tacklers in Overshown and Brockermeyer. And Brockermeyer, a knee injury on Tuesday in practice. And you think about the strength of this K-State team and Deuce Vaughn on the ground and being without their two of their starting linebackers, their top two tacklers, that will no question play a big role today.
Absolutely. And Coach Sark just, again, shaking his head and just bewildered by the whole season, really how this has all gone along. A non-contact injury takes out Brockermeyer.
And for Overshown, not exactly how you expected to be honored on senior day today. So 3rd and 7 now for K-State. Wildcats opening drive of the game.
And rush.
Howard, long throw to the boundary, not close to Malik Knowles. And it's 3 and out for K-State. And Will Howard in their opening drive.
Yeah, a little bit of a celebration, little sarcasm probably in the cheer from this crowd, the quick 3 and out. But just a rhythm throw there from Will Howard, certainly, as you said, out of rhythm with a guy he needs to find a way to get back in rhythm, Malik Knowles.
Chris Kleiman said that Skylar Thompson, there was an outside chance of him playing today. Injured that ankle. Fair catch called for by Deshaun Jameson. Well, Dicker, the kicker, who has done so much during his time with the Longhorns. Bring it down.
Look at him. Drop him up. Off.
Well, this Texas season recap has seen just about everything. Steve Sarkisian hired his head coach. They were ranked number 21 in the preseason AP. They began the year 4-1. In fact, they peaked at number 15 in the country. And then, boy, they've lost 6 straight, their longest losing streak since 1956. And what was going on in 1956? How about the great Coach Bill Snyder? He was a senior in high school.
Beautiful Coach Bill Snyder.
Goodness. It's a Thompson to pass. He wants it all. And it's underthrown, intercepted by T.J. Smith, his second pick this year. They were looking for Xavier Worthy once again, and it's an early turnover for Casey Thompson.
Sark trying to take a shot. Again, we know this is the best receiver, the young receiver in America, and so does K-State. They basically turn to a double team as he smokes by the double team of Ross Elder, trying to get a redirect. T.J. Smith, great vision. Great job coming back to the ball and just underthrown by Casey Thompson.
Smith had an interception in the opener versus Stanford. That was the first of his career, so he's booked into the regular season with a couple of picks. And after that tremendous opening drive for Texas, one play in the turnover, so here's Deuce Vaughn trying to find some space, and he lunges forward.
Good intensity so far by this Texas defense. Awareness, obviously, of Deuce Vaughn on every play, really rallying to get him on the ground. Again, a guy that runs way more physically than 5'6", 173 would indicate.
Well, they know Deuce Vaughn well from what he did last year to Texas. 170 total yards, a couple of touchdowns as well. He did that on just 10 carries.
3 tight ends, a fullback, and a tailback, and they're big boys.
Wildcat to Vaughn. K-State says we can do this also as Deuce Vaughn runs out of bounds right by the marker Pushed out of bounds by Jalen Ford. Above and Beyond, sponsored by Jersey. Might be a sub above. Well, how good is Deuce Vaughn? He's the only player in FBS with 1,000 yards on the ground plus 400 yards receiving. He's run for 100-plus in four straight games. It's the longest active streak in the conference. And 10 touchdowns over his last five games, most of the Big 12 during that span of time. Kind of an emotional game for Vaughn. He's a Texas guy, as you mentioned, from Round Rock. His father was a former assistant for the University of Texas, now a scout for the Cowboys. As Vaughn is able to put his foot in the ground and stumble forward for another good gain. As Vaughn is, it's like picked up nine.
It's like Jordan versus Bird or something. He says, okay, I saw that, Rashawn. Watch this. Whoop. There. I'm going to make you miss. Brendan Schooler coming out of the top end and not touching Deuce Vaughn. Trying to match Roschon Johnson down by the goal line.
Brings up second and short. You know, Vaughn is closing in on becoming just the fourth player in Big 12 history with 1,000 yards rushing and 500 yards receiving. He could easily hit the receiving mark today. He's got a 1,000-yard season on the ground already in the books. Play action, Howard rolls out. Malik Knowles has it up for the first down. Some yards after the catch as he scampers out of bounds. Always trying to find ways to get Malik Knowles more involved. Such a playmaker, so explosive.
Absolutely. Trying to get him involved in what turns into a return game, a screen, a little hitch out there. That's also a nice little drive starter, a rhythm creator for Will Howard. Flash fake to your guy. Get on the perimeter, get some green grass and play some green turf in front of you. Nice timing.
Picks up 10. K-State went 3-and-out on their opening drive. Much better success this time as Vaughn breaks an ankle tackle, gets a big hole and a first down inside the red zone. Another big gainer by Vaughn. That time good for 19.
One of my favorite guys on this K-State team is 29, Jack Stenine. He whiffs right there. Deuce says, I got you. You've helped me out a lot in the past. I'll help you out right now, and I'll still get to that third level of the defense, always finishing forward. An overly physical dude at 5'6", 172. The only thing he doesn't do great right now is protection. Obviously, a lot of that is just his girth, his stature, but he's willing.
First and 10 from the 20. Leading receiver for K-State, Phillip Brooks. Brooks is pushed out of bounds by Schooler after another good game.
Really nice distribution here by offensive coordinator Courtney Messingham. Get Deuce involved, get Malik involved, get our quarterback going. Now let's get Phillip on the perimeter. Nice job. You see Malik, Landry Weber, 12 and 4 in that case, blocking for Phillip Brooks.
Yeah, something to remember too for K-State. They are without their second string running back, change of pace guy Joe Irvin. Irvin did not make the trip.
Yeah, Slasher has been a very productive guy for them this year.
Vaughn's last three runs have been for 37 yards. They hand it to him again, trying to find the edge. Vaughn races inside the five, inside the pylon. Touchdown, K-State. Deuce Vaughn with another touchdown. It's his 15th on the ground this year.
All he needs is one step. We saw it on the previous play. Jackson here, 29. He's working to that inside backer. They lose contain, no edge to the defense. That's been a recurring, unfortunately, recurring theme for Pete Kwiatkowski's defense. Touchdown, Deuce.
Vaughn, start on that drive. 47 yards on the ground already for Deuce Vaughn. As Tennant puts it through. So Texas is a phenomenal opening drive. And then in the second drive for the Longhorns, Casey Thompson on the first play throws the pick. T.J. Smith with his second interception this year. Meanwhile, K-State went 3-and-out on their opening drive. And their second drive of the day results in Deuce Vaughn for 6, all tied in the first quarter. Fox College Football is sponsored by Pacific Life. More than 150 years strong. Protect what matters most.
Capital of the Republic of Texas right there. Beautiful shot.
It's a pleasant day in Austin. Temperatures in the 50s. Deuce Vaughn capping off a 7-play, 68-yard drive with a 9-yard touchdown run. His 15th touchdown run of the season. 18 total touchdowns this year for Deuce Vaughn. Jameson. Jameson with the seam and brought down just past the 25. Let's go back to the K-State touchdown from Vaughn.
Really nice execution here offensively. Watch Noah Johnson, the center, be the puller. Got a nice little down block here from Revis. And then Jax Dineen finishes on Barron to give Deuce just a window. It has to be Ray Thornton, 46, forcing upfield there. He gets just involved with Nick Leonard's that. Deuce doesn't need that big of a window. He'll do the rest.
Yeah, he finds the edge, and it's good night most of the time. We have an injured player for K-State. Nick Allen down for the Wildcats as they're tending to his left leg. Coach Chris Kleiman out there, along with the training staff. This is a time of year where everybody is banged up, of course. The last thing that any squad can afford is to lose another player. We've already mentioned the depth issues for Texas, and K-State has certainly been banged up and had plenty of question marks entering this game.
They're banged up everywhere. Lost Jerron McPherson, their again, just elite safety. Was out after last week. They lost another linebacker in the transfer portal during the Thanksgiving week preparations. Chris Kleiman, we've had a chance to get to know him a lot this year. Just really impressed with the trajectory, the momentum of this program. Again, probably not exactly where they want to be from a one-loss standpoint, but a huge turnaround from last season.
Now, Kleiman had a tremendous first year in Manhattan, and during the COVID season last year, of course, got wonky for everybody, but especially for K-State, and lost Skylar Thompson early that season. And now this year, Chris Kleiman has his Wildcats in position to win their eighth game of the season today as Allen is needing to be helped off the field. Kleiman, of course, just had a magnificent five-year run at North Dakota State, winning his fourth national championship in his final year. He went 69-6 at that level.
That's pretty good. Carson Wentz, years there at North Dakota State. Just a fundamental defensive football coach by training and has been an excellent head coach at any level.
Yeah, Kleiman did have a rule for the Thanksgiving team meal last night for K-State, and that was no mashed potatoes. Mashed potatoes were not allowed.
You're going to have like gravy or something.
Yeah, apparently mashed potatoes doesn't help with team speed, it sounds like. At least that was Kleiman's theory. Yeah, that could probably hold water. Change of direction from Robinson, who turns nothing into something. That looked like that was buried in the backfield. Keelan Robinson, the Alabama transfer, able to get something out of it.
That looked like they had a chance to get him stopped for nothing. And you said he's a dynamic guy, really hungry for carries with Bijan out, Roschon Johnson doing his thing. They're harder to come by. About half as many carries is Roschon.
Third drive for the Longhorns. First one resulted in six. Second drive was an interception on the first play. They toss it. Gotta find the edge. This is Jordan Whittington, who had the injured collarbone and missed significant time. One of the best receivers now back on the field for Texas.
You see a little jet sweep action there, the fake to Keelan Robinson. And it is great to have Jordan Whittington back. He's a guy, he's a sophomore, but a ton of experience, as you said. And a really, really savvy guy for a young fella.
It was really thought initially that he would be lost for the year. He did return last week. He was really used more of a decoy than anything.
Right. They really need him to compliment Worthy and really K-Pool right now in their attack.
Johnson stumbles forward. He runs into Daniel Green, K-State's leading tackler.
Keelan Robinson, for the K-State fans, is a little bit like Joe Irvin, kind of a slasher, the transfer from Alabama, and physical at the top.
Second and seven for Texas. To pass. There is Whittington once again. He's got a first down to midfield.
Sell that counter again. I think this is an RPO where they have the option to hand the ball off, or Whittington, this is what I was talking about, the field just sits. Nice little approach here and a good little target for Casey Thompson. Bang, bang, first down.
Yeah, they really thinned out at the receiver position when Whittington was out. Joshua Moore entered the transfer portal. He led them in yards, catches, and touchdowns last year. Roshon Johnson in the Wildcat. He keeps it. It's been effective for Texas early today. Johnson with a touchdown run already. Runs into Ross Elder coming off a career game. 10 tackles last week for Elder against Baylor. Seven.
Yeah, it was interesting talking to Coach Sark this week and his approach, and he was alluding, it seemed like, to a little bit more Wildcat, probably not as much as we, or probably more than we expected, but it really gets your best guys the ball when Casey Thompson, Hudson Card, these other guys, they're not a run threat. These other guys, you can flash fake it, you just run the base offense, and it looks a little bit different.
And Texas taking its time on this drive, slowing the tempo down as Robinson is met and stuffed. That was Jalen Pickle. Third and short now.
Yeah, Jalen Pickle has had enough. See him 9-3, getting double teamed here as Jared Wiley works off of him, splits that double team of the tackle and tight end, and another Longhorn throw.
That's Tope Amata, a senior out of Arlington, sixth year senior, in fact. See him able to walk off the field on his own power. He's pretty braced up.
Yeah, just a massive human being. 6'6", 61. They'll pull him sometimes. He's a lot more athletic than you think at that side. Arlington Bowie High School. Dallas area.
Tamane, who is playing a pretty emotional game today on senior day. For all seniors, but especially for the six-year senior out of Arlington. And this time they go direct snap to Cade Brewer, the tight end, who goes under center. And he's able to push the pile forward. That's a new one. An already pretty creative day offensively for Texas.
Yeah, nice little record. The thing you got to do here is if you're Cade Brewer, you got to make sure you get set. It looks like he does for about a count. That's a little close. And then get the physical there in behind Hayden Connor in there for Amata.
And the pistol. And off to Johnson, trying to spin his way forward, but instead Julius Brents wraps him up at the 40. It's a loss of one.
Julius Brents, we talked about him earlier. He is a physical guy. They love this guy with his length. 6'4", was at the University of Iowa, transferred in this year. Has really played well. He had three tackles last week, but it sure seemed like a bunch more than that.
Tope Amade, we were talking about an emotional day today for the sixth-year senior. His late mother, he carries a framed photo of her as he is honored out of the tunnel prior to kick today on senior day. An emotional day for many, but especially for Tope Amade.
That's awesome.
That takes us to the end of the first quarter. While Texas trying to salvage what is left of this season after losing six in a row, K-State bowl bound, looking for their eighth win. One quarter in the books, a couple of rushing touchdowns, one on each side, tied after one. Tied at seven as we open up the second quarter from Texas. Our team comparison is sponsored by Credible.com. Both teams heavy on the ground game in the first quarter. The turnover from Texas, the Casey Thompson interception. And one of the stories so far has been third down for the Longhorns. They're 3-for-3. Now third and two, they go Wildcat. And it's Johnson who picks up another third down conversion for Texas. That's been third and short nearly every time.
Yeah, they've done a great job on first and second down, as you said, getting to those third and shorts. And here's a Wildcat. This is not a read. It's just a flash it in there, load it up. Get Cade Brewer coming to the backside and let Roshon Johnson do his thing. First down, Horns.
And picks up 16. It's been nothing longer than third and three today for Texas. And now converted all four third down tries. inside the 15. Xavier Worthy able to elude one tackle and now brought down. It was T.J. Smith who had the pick earlier. It was a heavy dose of Worthy in that opening drive, in quiet sense.
Watch this motion. You're going to see Stubblefield, number one, coming right there. Missing. Nice job by Worthy getting something out of that. Or even getting back to the line of scrimmage. But yeah, Texas is doing a nice job with their base. You know, a couple of funky formations, but that's one thing when you look at this Texas team. They do a million things, and that's just a sign of trying to find what are.
Keelan Robinson spin cycles his way forward to the 10. Another tackle from Daniel Graney. Picks up 5. Oh, we were talking about 3rd and 3 or fewer. This time a little longer. 3rd and 6 now. Sergeant Calvin.
That comes off that jet sweep getting blown up at the line of scrimmage for nothing. It's all about that first down play.
Now their average to go on 3rd down, just 2 yards. Counter that to 7 for the Wildcats. Thompson to pass, looking end zone, looking for Brewer. Brewer in traffic, and Cade Brewer, what a catch, what a ball. Texas touchdown. The super senior on senior day in traffic. Able to haul that one in.
Everybody anticipating these throws to the perimeter for Worthy, and he did a little stop and go that time by Brewer. And a good throw, good location from Thompson, and a better catch from the veteran Cade Brewer over, in that case, Julius Brents and Russ East.
Only thing they could hope for was that Brewer was out of bounds. A perfect placement from Thompson. Dangerous pass.
Now, the motion went over. It's the same play they ran earlier. Play off of that play that they threw to Worthy. They'll pump to him. You see him over. They have the Iowa transfer Brents, the Louisville transfer Easton. Two of those don't equal Cade Brewer.
A 3rd touchdown catch this year for Brewer. He's put together a nice career with the Longhorns.
Can't see the ball from the back angle, but making sure that there was a little movement of that ball before it hit the ground, but it sure looked like he secured it from this angle. And it's confirmed.
A 13-play drive with 10 running plays on the drive, but it's a touchdown pass to cap it off. How about this Texas offense? It has struggled so mightily. We mentioned earlier that Casey Thompson had been benched twice in the last 3 games. Is this? Looks like they were conferring there.
You don't see that very often. Yeah. Conferring. They had to make a decision, and no good.
So Dicker, so reliable, misses the PAT.
The officials are going, man, he's 48 to 48. There's no way he missed it. Off the throw from Thompson to Brewer. Perfect location. Great finish. And then go buy a lottery ticket today. Cameron Dicker missed a PAT. 49 of 50 on the year.
Now Cameron Dicker has put together one of the great careers of any Texas kicker in program history. Drills the upright. And the officials, for some reason, needed some time to sort that one out. Maybe they just...
Couldn't believe he missed the PAT. Shot.
A short kick. This is Phillip Brooks. Brooks on the return. Jeff Schooler with the tackle. Safety for the Longhorns on special team.
Texas done that to a lot of your better returners in the conference and who they played, the pooch game, the squib game. Nice job getting Phillip Brooks on the ground.
I'm trying to get things away from Malik Knowles if you're Texas. Will Howard making his 3rd start this year. He started 7 games last year as a true freshman. Skyler Thompson can't go today with an injured ankle. 6th-year super senior. Howard started against Texas last year, threw for a couple of touchdowns, ran for nearly 80 yards, but turned the ball over 3 times. He keeps it himself. And Howard's got a first down and more. He's streaking down the sideline. Will Howard is on his way, and he dives in. And Will Howard is in for a touchdown. 71 yards, Will Howard for six.
One for one. He's reading the right defensive angles. You're looking at it. You see his eyes there. They travel with Deuce Vaughn. Gets his buddy Logan Long to escort him to the secondary. And he's gone. Logan Vaughn is gone. They didn't understand how he could run by Deshaun Jameson as he tries to poke it out there the last second. Touchdown, Cats. Immediate response.
And he's feeling it for good reason. Feeling he'll be showing Deuce Vaughn that in film study not long from now. So K-State immediately answers. You know, for Howard, his career rushing total was 102 yards entering today. He rips off a 71-yarder for a touchdown on the first play of the drive. Fox College Football is sponsored by Discover, exceptionally common sense. And by Cerveza Dos Equis, get a dose, please drink responsibly. Last two meetings between these teams in Austin have both been walk-off wins for the Longhorns. Thicker involved the last time, the walk-off field goal. Now, the first 10 plays on offense for K-State resulted in 71 total yards. Will Howard just ripped off a 71-yard touchdown run. I mentioned his career rushing yards prior to today. He nearly matched that in one run. Let's go back to that touchdown run.
Really nice execution here from Will Howard. So here's TG's reading. This defensive end, you'll see the center and the backside tackle pull. If that defensive end runs with Deuce Vaughn, as he does here, Will Howard keeps it, and he's gone. So there it is. End sits. Howard keeps. Nice job by Logan Long, 71, getting into the free safety, who takes a bad angle. Jay Foster, this might be my favorite part of it. This guy here, hey, you, gone. You're gone. He's doing that with a lot of K-State fans at home. Having a little Thanksgiving leftovers, celebrating Will Howard touchdown.
What an answer for K-State. Texas, the missed point after, so K-State leading by one now. Pass it on play action. Now turns into a runner. He'll tuck and slide. Just shy of the 35.
That is a really positive play. Doesn't look like much, right? He's not Will Howard in terms of his production as a runner, but any positive play right there, setting up second and three there in business. Doesn't make the critical error he did earlier of forcing that pick. Coach Sark likes that. Second and three.
And on second and three, they hand to Johnson, who runs into a wall. He's pushed back. Jalen Pickle once again. He's been active on the interior. It's a loss of two.
Stubblefield doing a great job here. Pickle being very active. 6'4", 300. You'll see one Stubblefield set the edge right there. Cut the ball back. Pickle, good rally.
And this is one of the most stout run defenses in the country, K-State. And they were able to manage one of the elite rushing attacks last week of Baylor. I'm sorry, their third tackle for loss today. Thompson on 35, incomplete. Whittington was there. Texas was maybe hoping for some contact, but Stubblefield on good coverage. And it brings on fourth down.
Yeah, had a chance if that's thrown to the inside armpit as he's running. Jordan Whittington inside. Got a chance there to convert. Just to look like a miss from Casey Thompson. A little bit of late pressure, but a big third down stop from K-State. As you said, they played well defensively last week. An initial three and out, and then a muffed punt really led to that first touchdown for Baylor. He's playing well.
Phillip Brooks calls for the fair catch.
And it was that man that muffed it last week. That's a positive for him.
Well, tomorrow there are games, and then there's the game. It's the latest chapter in college football's ultimate rivalry. Number 2 Ohio State takes on number 5 Michigan. And the big noon Saturday game of the week coverage begins at 10 Eastern with big noon kickoff live from Ann Arbor. And then it's the game tomorrow on Fox and the Fox Sports app. And so the winner will clinch the East and advance to the Big Ten championship game. Look at what Ohio State has done offensively, especially what they did to Michigan State. Number 1 scoring offense in the country. Michigan, number 7 scoring defense. So something will have to give there. And Jim Harbaugh looking for his first win against the Buckeyes.
Who you got?
Howard rolls out, and he finds Dineen, who throws a stiff arm. Dineen, the native of Lawrence in Jayhawk territory. That's not a word you want to use around this Longhorn program. Ever since Kansas came to town and shot the Longhorns. That's a pick of a 6.
Yeah, Dineen bluffing the block as he comes backside. He's built like a rectangle. Look at that dude. He's like a sawed-off phone booth. He's blocking fools mostly by soft hands. Not enough beating the fullback this year. He's usually just doing the dirty work. And that was a huge compliment, by the way. I saw off
phone booth. You need to explain what a phone booth is to some folks.
No doubt.
Vaughn up the middle.
Yeah, he's going to be short here, but just another bang it in there. Keep him honest, run. Nice drive starter that time from offensive coordinator Courtney Messingham. And they're in business at 3rd and 2. Here's all your, everything your playbook you want. Will Howard's a runner. Will Howard could be a leader. Or just give it to your guy, Deuce Vaughn. Balance situation, all the eligible receivers up top, nobody down here.
They decide to pass, and that completed. Eric Hommel, the seldom used senior out of Littleton, Colorado, on the reception for first down.
RPO, the corner is off. Well, do that. Don't worry about blocking all those guys, just throw the hitch out there. Love Deshaun Jameson there to press and not allow that to happen and force him to grind it out.
And a great celebration for Hommel. First reception. And the senior gets one in before it's all done. Howard taking a shot, twisting around. He was looking for Landry Weber, incomplete. He's done on the coverage.
Their base concept's basically a double post type of concept with a crosser from the backside. Trying to just take a shot, anticipating Texas defense. You know, Deuce Vaughn, Will Howard as a runner. That's a little keep him honest for Chris Klein's side. Balls up. Got it back.
Came right back to him. Thompson on the tackle for the Longhorns.
A little juggling act there from Deuce Vaughn. Dineen, little motion, little slide motion to come outside. He cuts it back. Deuce Vaughn does that so well. Has a great feel for being powerful. Oh. Nice little strip.
That was Thompson on the strip momentarily.
Yeah. Jared Thompson almost ripped it out. Deuce saves it 3rd and 4.
Third and manageable for K-State. They bring Vaughn back to the backfield. They hand to Deuce Vaughn. Vaughn not going far enough. Longhorns and Jet Bush.
I felt like, hey, we're going for it on 4th down. If we get a little something here on that play, we'll see what Chris Klein does on that side of the 50. He's fairly conservative in these situations, but we'll see. Just nothing else going, no other element that seemed like a, hey, we're going to go for a 4th down, but they're going to punt.
They bring on Ty Zinder.
Texas has their safe return. Just the returner is in there. Everybody else is a defensive player.
Jameson calling for the fair catch at the 12. Well, this one's been a little bit back and forth. We're seeing a heavy dose of the ground game. Deuce Vaughn involved early, already a rushing touchdown. Brewer with the touchdown catch for Texas.
one.
Time to celebrate Fansville and college football's return to glory with an ice-cold Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve. And when you are in the great state of Texas, my friend, you're drinking one thing only. At least during the daytime, and that would be an ice-cold Dr. Pepper.
Ice-cold Dr. Pepper. What kind of Coke you want, Dr. Pepper?
That's all there is. Casey Thompson. And this running play smothered at the 10, going nowhere. Daniel Green and Reggie Stubblefield, it's a loss of two. Keelan Robinson engulfed.
Stubblefield off the edge from here. They're coming off of both sides. Defensive coordinator Coach Klannerman kind of seen enough here, trying to heat this thing up and attack it in the backfield.
And K-State moving to the 3-3-5 this year. They've simplified things kind of mid-season. Try to get their guys to be able to play a little faster. Thompson under pressure. Thompson is buried by Eli Huggins, the senior out of Georgia. And K-State living in the backfield. The sack from Huggins, the sixth tackle for loss for the Wildcats already.
So many of their tackles for loss and their sacks are just effort. A lot of times it's a three-man rush. Here's the man who gets the sack, Huggins, 91, and Udike Uzama forcing Thompson to him, and just to get a great effort from Eli Huggins.
Yeah, Felix and Udike Uzama has been one of the nation's great sack artists this year. He leads the conference. Well, this time it's Huggins. Junior Angilau, a junior out of Salt Lake City, injured on the play. Good to see him able to get up. Chris Kleiman now his third year, and you look at sacks by season under Kleiman. Year one, eighth in the conference. Last year, an improvement to fourth, and this year, even better at third. And there's no question, and Udike Uzama is a big part of that.
Absolutely, and it turned around at Texas Tech. They had three straight losses. They're down at Texas Tech, and Udike Uzama creates a safety that turned the tide not only for that game, but for that guy's career. He has been a rock star ever since.
He's a true sophomore. Came to Manhattan pretty slender, just 215, has bulked up to 255 now, and has become one of the great playmakers on any deep line of the conference or the country. Third and very long, Thompson checks down to his tight end Brewer. He's trying to get some kind of yardage here. Shy of the 20, tackled by Cody Fletcher. Flashback to the safety you were just talking about.
They were down 24-10, right, up against the ropes, and they've got him backed up. Him defeating that blocker, getting him down, that turned around again, not only that game, but his self-confidence, his belief in what they were doing defensively, again, has been outstanding.
Yeah, it's been a huge defensive turnaround for K-State. Just struggling the first three games in conference against the three best teams in the Big 12. This takes a Longhorn roll. 42. We will step aside as Will Howard and K-State's offense takes over next. Fox College Football is sponsored by Cadillac. It's been a long year for Bevo and company.
What a great mascot.
Final home game of the year and a staple. Our Pacific Life game summary, sponsored by Pacific Life, more than 150 years strong. Total yards about even. Yards per play, however, favoring the Wildcats. Of course, Will Howard had that 71-yard touchdown run. The stories for Sark's offense has been third and manageable so often. They're 5-for-7 on third down. And Roshan Johnson was certainly a star of that opening drive. He's a touchdown run for the Longhorns. As Howard goes under center on first and 10. Position for K-State. Vaughn wrapped up by Anthony Cook. That's a pickup of just three.
Nice job by Jackson in that time. Front side on the edge and allowing Deuce some room on the cutback. Really good job rallying to get him down. Had a chance at a bigger play.
Now for Will Howard, Him starting today burns what was a planned red shirt for Howard. He's playing in his fifth game. Had he not played today, he could have conceivably gone into next year still athletically in terms of classification as a freshman. Is he lost a mouth guard on that run right there from Bond. Something went flying. Now, this is a conversation that Chris Kleiman had with Will Howard after a pickup of 10 on that carry. And Howard was more than willing to burn the red shirt and play today. Yep,
didn't hesitate. That's great to see. You play behind that guy, Skylar Thompson. You know, unfortunately, he's been dinged up. You know there's a chance he might play. But at this point, this season just says a lot about Will Howard, man. He wants to grab this opportunity not only for himself, for his teammates.
Direct snap to Vaughn. Bad idea. Jalen Ford pancakes him in the backfield.
Yeah, another guy taking advantage of his first start in there for Brockermeyer. Along with Benda, you'll see 41 coming out of the backfield and almost knocking this loose again. Deuce not anticipating that. KT Leviston, got to keep his eyes up on that second level.
It's a loss of one. Just over 4 minutes to play in the first half, second and 11. They bring Malik Knowles into the backfield. They hand to Knowles. The wide receiver has a hole. He turns up field and keeps the legs turning after contact. He's got a first down.
Here's another way we talked about this with Coach Kleiman, is how many different ways can we get Malik Knowles? This is their Xavier Worthy, right, in some ways, is how many explosive plays can we create, or how many unique ways can we get him the ball? Nice little motion to the backfield.
And picks up 13. Okay. And another man down for Texas.
Gosh, a lot of guys down today.
Seen it often here in the first half, unfortunately. All right, now let's go ahead and check in with Rob Stone and see what's coming up on the State Farm Halftime Show. Rob?
On the State Farm Halftime, we'll talk about the first half of this K-State-Texas game, plus highlights, number 21, San Diego State in action, and we'll look ahead to the big showdown from the Big House tomorrow. Can Michigan end that ugly 8-game losing streak against the Buckeyes? Aaron, Coach, we'll see you guys at the half.
Yeah, Rob's eyes are watering up there a little bit. I don't think he's getting emotional. I just think it happens to be a little chilly there.
Be that cold.
Ann Arbor.
Yeah.
Moro Ojimo is down for Texas. Good to see him at least sitting up now. And what a big one on tap tomorrow. Let's see what happened to Ojimo. Nice to see him being able to walk off on his own power.
Yeah, both those big guys, you see him in chase mode. That's just, again, it's just a lot of mass that they're playing. They're playing hard, pursuing on the ball carrier. Making sure everything back together. Looks good to go. That's a D-line, good to go. You do that one little test, all right, I'm good.
That's all it takes. It was a first down run by Malik Knowles. Designed run for Howard. Tiptoe over a tackler, but brought down by the ankle.
Yeah, you are exactly right. If he hits it, the thing about this is he's got to let his blocks develop just a little bit. But if he hits it right in this little, called the D-gap crease, outside the tight end, just gets forced here a little bit, and there's not enough room between the Deneen and the puller, and he's tripping. Credit that time to, I believe that was a gopher there on the tackle.
Yeah, from Notre Dame transfer. Howard, he keeps it again, and again he is wrapped up. Deshaun Jameson this time, the senior, keeps that play from developing.
Nice job by Jameson. Deuce Vaughn and the center end up going to the same guy. If Deuce expands there and blocks Jameson, and a lot more running room on that design quarterback draw.
Well, we know how much of a priority, how much of an emphasis it will be today and already has been for K-State to run Will Howard. I mean, he had the big gainer, 71-yard touchdown run, but other than that, Texas has been, by and large, able to contain him.
Huge play here. K-State having some issues with these longer field goals.
With protection, checks down to Vaughn, and Vaughn's not anywhere close. Avant, so dynamic, as a receiver as well. Most catches for this K-State team. He's trotting off the field now on fourth and long.
He covers that time. Four-man rush from Texas to put anything at risk. Just a basic four-man rush, zone coverage, and a 51-yarder coming up.
This would be by far the career long for the true freshman, Chris Tennant. Tennant has the leg, and Tennant puts it through, a career-best 51-yard field goal for the true freshman, Chris Tennant. And for a young man who has had his struggles from shorter distance, he just smoked a rocket through the uprights. 17-13 Wildcats.
Late. Tremendous job holding on to that from Worthy.
Just an awful landing right on his back. Slightly built wide receiver who is having really a historic season. And truly been one of the best receivers in the country. Brewer had a touchdown catch earlier today. Pushed out of bounds by Julius Brents.
It was Texas that took that timeout earlier, so they're operating here with two timeouts left. About 21 is really still trying to get himself right on the sideline.
Now he has long passed Longhorn legend Roy Williams for the program record for most receiving touchdowns by a freshman. Williams had eight back in 2000. Worthy's got a dozen this year. Johnson trying to find room to run. Look at where Xavier Worthy stacks up. I mean, forget freshman. For any receiver in program history, he's now just one touchdown catch shy of Jordan Shipley's 2009 season when Shipley hauled in 13 for the most in Longhorn history.
It's Longhorn royalty right there.
Yes, it is.
Timeout, Texas. The second of the half, 30-second timeout.
One timeout remaining for the Longhorns, back in 30 seconds. Xavier Worthy trying to get loose after taking that hard fall on a first down catch where he was upended by T.J. Smith after leaving his feet. And somehow he's looking all right.
Wildcat action there. I thought it, as they came out of this timeout, this is, hey, my guy, capital G guy's not in there.
Ooh, Roshan Johnson thinking about passing. Instead, he'll hold on to it, take a lick at the 30, and keep on chugging. Roshan Johnson has enough for the first down. Reggie Stubblefield was there to greet him. Things almost got real interesting there for a moment.
Little nice little app. What's the plan? Let's break it down. Play action pass, a little ride to side. I'll check it down. No, I am one of the greatest running backs, at least here. Break some tackles, get vertical, first down.
But he went through some progressions there.
He did. His eyes appeared to at least look. Thought they might go with a little hardball action off that. Steve Sarkisian had the truck car.
Is drilled by Green, is able to get rid of it just in time. He had a man in the vicinity, but Thompson was crushed by Daniel Green.
Coach Kleinerman, again, annoyed, just bringing Daniel Green from the inside, has been outstanding this year. Last week, nine tackles, a sack, three tackles for loss, and this is a big-time hurry and a shot on Casey Thompson. Had to be in the vicinity, as you said, of a receiver because he is inside the tackle box. Casey Thompson making sure he's okay.
Well, you can, first of all, you can see the wrap on his thumb that he's been dealing with, and then you can see him holding his head after getting some whiplash there. And they will go Wildcat. Once again, for good reason here, they're going to give Thompson a chance to clear his head. Worthy back in the game. They hand to Xavier Worthy. He's thinking. He heaves it to the end zone. Washington, a flag is out. The ball is dropped. And he was looking for Marcus Washington. Julius Brents on the coverage.
Worthy can pretty much do everything as well here. Tries to sell it. That is a hand-to-hand snap. That is huge right there. That makes this play legal. If he flips it to him, that's a forward pass. He's like working the fadeaway, trying to draw the flag. He loves the flag. Gonna go back and get his mouthpiece. We'll take a look. Like Prince was in good position.
Defense, number 23.
Take more patience. That's the hardest part of the corner.
First down.
Late patience, late hands that you attack. Tight red area here for Texas. 29 seconds.
So PI on Brents, not playing the ball. First and 10 now. And see what the quarterback situation turns out now.
That's like dial a quarterback and he's got a roulette wheel on the sideline.
Dobson. Down by NUDK Uzama.
Got Ben Ballard in there, quarterback 17, a true quarterback, the third string quarterback as it lays today. And then Roshan Johnson and Keenan Robinson. They take a timeout there last of the first half. Great physical finish from NUDK Uzama.
We've seen a full buffet of direct snaps to Roshan Johnson here in the first half. Felix Anudike Uzama leading the nation, forcing six fumbles this year. His 11 sacks are good for third best in the country in terms of tackles for loss. There have been few that have been better than the K-State standout this season.
K-State faithful say, hey, right about now would be a perfect time to break out that seventh forced fumble to end this impressive Texas drive. A couple trick plays, a lot of wildcat action.
And Baylor was able to contain him fairly well last week.
Yeah, and now Casey Thompson is back in.
Thompson needed a couple of plays after taking a shot. Second and 8. Worthy wants the flag. He's not getting one. It was Echo Boydo on the coverage. Worthy wants those flags when he's throwing or trying to receive.
Absolutely. They brought 7 here, so man coverage on the edge on the outside. No help. 0 man. Just a little too much running to the sideline there for Worthy. If he gets a little bit better release, he's going to put a little more pressure on that official. No chance, sir. Just ask Echo Boydo. No chance.
Third and 8 now. Thompson keeps. Thompson. Drop just shy of the 5.
And hustle. No timeouts. Fourth down.
Pick around quickly. And the hurry-up field goal unit is able to poke it through.
That was great execution from that Texas sideline. You're so worried about that interchange. You know, and this is right at the cusp, and they did such a good job. Look at that clock. It was right at 16 seconds. Snap the ball, quarterback draw. He hustles up, gets down, and then watch the sideline. In and out, inside and out, you have a couple terms for this to go in and out as quickly as possible. The offensive player should run to the sideline. Special teams got to get set. Make sure the kicker's ready. Great execution.
Perfectly done by Texas. And that's the end of the first half. 17-16. K-State coming up after this quick commercial break. It's the State Farm Halftime Show with Rob Stone and the guys from Ann Arbor. Football sponsored by AT&T Business. Welcome once again, Aaron Goldfield, alongside Coach Mark Helfrich. Mark, this Longhorns offense has had its struggles at times over the course of this season, but in the first half, we've seen some of that Sark creativity take over.
They did a great job offensively. It's been a pick your quarterback, just a dial of quarterback rotation, done a bunch of stuff with the Wildcat. Let's look at plays off of a play. The motion here from Kate Brewer out, showing the screen pass to Xavier Worthy. K-State blows it up. Texas talks about this, right? They say before, hey, we've got to use Xavier as a decoy. We got to find our guy. Cade, the same exact action, same exact motion. There's the pump and just enough room over the top of Julius Brents. Great effort and finish by Kate Burr and good design by Sark.
That's our second half connection brought to you by AT&T Business, keeping your business connected with AT&T 5G. On K-State outgaining Texas. Overall, have the edge in total yards. They've been very effective on third down as well. They've run noticeably more plays than K-State as Dicker kicks it away. K-State with a one-point lead to begin the second half. They start with the ball in the hands of Malik Knowles on the return. Knowles, galloping past the 40 and knocked out of bounds again by Dicker, who's been very active, not just with his legs so far today. So good field position for Will Howard and this K-State offense.
That is huge. Out of the locker room, Phillip Brooks, 88, setting him up, getting his guy going, get the double team on Schooler. And this is a great return, but he will take some grief. That's the second shot by Dicker, the kicker, Dicker, the tackler. But sets him up in business for Malik Knowles.
We did not pay off the promised Dicker Zintner kicker tackling package that we were.
It's gone viral. That's all.
Good starting field position for the Wildcats as Will Howard goes under center and a flag right away to start the second half.
Perfect balance, as you said, from Texas offensively. 106 on the ground, 101 to the air.
Not having offside defense with contact. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Howard, 76 yards rushing, 71 of those coming on a touchdown run. Meanwhile, Deuce Vaughn has scored on the ground 70 yards in total and trying to get the ball in the hands of Malik Knowles. He's had a catch and a carry. Vaughn, a first down run. Vaughn down the sideline and pushed out of bounds. He continues marching towards what would be his fifth straight 100-yard effort.
Just a predetermined cutback here from Deuce Vaughn, trying to get everybody flowing to the right, to the offensive right, get the offense pulling that way, slip back in behind Deneen and get it going. Great start here for K-State. The kickoff return, the offsides on the first down play, and a big gain for your star.
That's a pickup of 16. Vaughn now with 86 yards on the day, plus the touchdown. Right away inside Texas territory. Vaughn with a nifty shake. Good block from Jackson Dean as well. Vaughn continuing to move the chains.
Yeah, just follow 2-9. That'll take you to the ball. Leaking on the perimeter, oh, and just a great finish on a go-fu. A Deuce Vaughn sees the other blocker kind of shedded. That's not good to K-State seeing Jackson Dean on the sideline. Got to figure out some way to keep him honest in the passing game here. K-State only 32 yards passing.
The motion, Phillip Brooks. Brooks, the leading receiver for K-State. Gets a touch here, trying to give ground. The game ground is given a lot and is brought down for a massive loss. Anthony Cook there. Jacoby Jones as well, who is coming off of foot surgery, has missed the last five games.
Getting that edge there again. If you're Will Howard, you see that guy upfield. I'm guessing that wasn't a read in that case, but he's unblocked. Usually they'll read that guy. They'll pull it just like he did on the long touchdown run. Anticipate them coming back to that another run to the other side.
It's got to feel good for Jones. He's missed so much time. It's a loss of 10. Howard keeping it and not going anywhere. David Benda brings on fourth and very long.
Good rally. Good answer there from that Texas defense. Couldn't, again, have started out worse. They work it to third and 14. They swarmed. They had a little quick game screen to the field that they swarmed to. And Will Howard tries to make something out of nothing.
Yeah, knocked out of any chance for field goal range. Tennant hit a 51-yarder in the first half. It was a career long for the true freshman. Zintner on to punt. Nose down punt, trying to pin the Longhorns. And a good punt inside the 10. So after K-State got great starting field position on the return from Knowles, it was a big TFL for the Longhorns and a punt for the Wildcats. Fox College Football is sponsored by Dr. Pepper. Delicious, ice-cold Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve. And by Ram Trucks. J.D. Power's number one brand in new vehicle quality. Second half has been a struggle for Texas at times this year. They led Oklahoma 28-7 in Red River, lost 55-48 in a wild shootout. They were on top of number 12 Oklahoma State at home. They're on top 17-3, but ended up losing. And then in Waco, leading 21-10 going to the fourth quarter, and losing 31-24. They trailed by one here. Begin the second half. They motion Xavier Worthy. Instead, they hand it off to Robinson. And Robinson is brought down for a loss by Daniel Green. Green is having a heck of an afternoon. It's a loss of two.
22 deuce green. They call him. Just fires through the gap, reads the run, beats the offensive lineman with athleticism, and then punishes the runner.
Now he's been a monster today. He has been all season, really. Seventh tackle for loss today for K-State. Robinson gets a hole to run through, stays on his feet. Elder couldn't finish the tackle, and he gets nearly out to the 15. You know, Robinson coming off a career best 111 yards and a touchdown versus West Virginia. Picks up 11 on this carry, sets up third and short.
Just to get a physical, violent finish here from Keelan Robinson. 19, Ross Elder's going to come to the left of your screen, a sure tackler. He runs right through him. Makes Eastman miss and gets all the way to the last man standing. They're just up here.
Well, Bijan Robinson lost for the season with a dislocated elbow, one of the best backs in the country. And they go Wildcat here. Roshan Johnson and Keelan Robinson in the backfield. Rex knocked to Johnson, needed a yard. And it's short. Gimpy getting out of the pile.
Yeah, just his initial cut. You'll see this just kind of wad up. They try to kick out Stubblefield. Good job setting the edge. And no surprise, Daniel Green meets him in the backfield. No doubt he is short.
Now, Russ Yeast is letting you know that's short of the first down. Fourth and one. Dicker, who does it all on special teams for Texas, he kicks off.
Got too many guys out there. There they go.
This field goals, extra points, and now punts this year as well. Standing at his own one. Punts from five. A good starting field position for K-State. Brooks, the fair catch. And a short field ahead for K-State on what is a gorgeous Thanksgiving weekend from Austin, Texas. Fox College Football is sponsored by Liberty Mutual Insurance. Only pay for what you need. And by High Noon Hard Seltzer. Please sunsip responsibly. The Wildcats have a strong lineage of tremendous quarterbacks who wore number 7, Michael Bishop, right at the top of that list. He is on the sidelines for K-State, now living in Texas, and just led the high school team that he coaches to a state Texas championship, which is no small feat, as you know, Mark.
Michael Bishop is a stud. One of the most underrated quarterbacks of all time.
Yeah, he was a dude. There's no question about that. Had a little time in the NFL in Canada as well. Howard, play action. Rolls the pocket. Launching and underthrown. Looking for Phillip Brooks. Brennan Schooler for the coverage.
Almost couldn't believe his eyes as he came out. If he lets that go early, he's got a chance. You see Brooks kind of a little over route and goes. Got to take it up that hash. That ball just has to be out way earlier. No chance.
One of my biggest memories of watching Michael Bishop is when he threw an interception, which didn't happen often.
Right.
But when he did, nobody wanted to get tackled on the man who picked it off more than Michael Bishop. He could lay the lumber. Trying to get the ball in the hands of Malik Knowles. Olajuwo with the tackle for Texas.
And for Brockermeyer, Jalen Ford, 91, kind of forces this back in. It gets the help from Olajuwo. Goes underneath the blocker there. Both defenses responding well in these first two drives. Another big third down here.
Yeah, K-State's defense came up with a big stop on third and short. And their offense has struggled on third down today. Third and long for Howard. Over the middle and had 2 men in the vicinity. It's incomplete. Knowles was there. Sammy Wheeler, the tight end. And the punt unit comes on for the Wildcats.
Yeah, in this scheme, it looks like Wheeler is in the right spot. I don't think Knowles is supposed to be there, and he gets to miss. No pressure picked up. They ended up dropping one out, only rushing 4. But great response by this Texas defense.
Well, K-State is leading with 9 minutes to play in the third quarter, having thrown for just 32 yards today. Zentner, a running catch by Jameson, who keeps his feet, sheds another tackle, and you have to be impressed by the effort there from Jameson. Brings it out nearly to the 20. Well, we got a close one today on this Thanksgiving weekend. Texas and K-State from Austin, Wildcats by 1. Tomorrow it's a big doubleheader on Fox. First at 4 Eastern, 14th ranked Wisconsin looks to punch their ticket to the Big Ten Championship as they take on Minnesota. Then at 8, 6th ranked Notre Dame battles Stanford. It's all on Fox and the Fox Sports app. Wisconsin hasn't lost since the second day of October. They've won 7 in a row. And an impossible schedule to begin the season. Wisconsin on play action. Tries to step up. It's a shovel pass off to Roshan Johnson. What a play by Casey Thompson. That was impressive.
Yeah, play action pass off that jet sweep motion that they've worked a lot the last few weeks. And there was nothing downfield. K-State had it gloved on the back end. You see Casey Thompson go through the progression. There's his post route. Where's Cade Brewer? He's covered. Where's my check down? Great catch. Great effort getting it to him.
As the electrifying freshman brought down by the ankles. Good tackle by Echo Boydo. That's been a matchup to watch all day long.
Absolutely. That's that action we showed off earlier with Brewer in motion. He along with Marcus Washington, 15, lead blocking for Xavier Worthy. And it is buckle up every time that guy has the ball.
And Worthy, who took a hard hit on an airborne catch earlier. Second and 1. Johnson tries to cut up field, brought down by the ankle. Reggie Stubblefield and Daniel Green. Stubblefield got him down by the feet.
Yeah, you'll see both Stubblefield and Green really trigger to stop and get this play moving flat. Great defense from Kansas State. Unaccounted for in that scheme.
Green, a native of Portland, Oregon. Kind of a weird recruiting spot for the Wildcats, but was a huge get for K-State. Former 4-star recruit, got some SEC offers. Up the middle, Johnson, tackled by Elder. He's able to move the sticks. Both these teams with a pretty heavy emphasis on the ground game today.
Absolutely. Texas is balancing up the yardage, just a little bit more production, and turn those into points in both realms. They brought Fletcher and Green there, trying to stop that 3rd and 2. Good answer from Coach Salk.
First catch of the day for Dixon, who gets crunched by Reggie Stubblefield. Russ East there as well. Dixon's moved up the depth chart this season.
He takes a shot, little bubble screen, good protection from Whittington, and heads up, Yeast is coming in.
You know, for Stubblefield, this game a really meaningful one for him. He grew up in the state of Texas. He calls Arlington home. He was born in Lubbock. He said when he was younger, he wanted to play for the Longhorns. Thompson with time. Pump fake. Now check down to Johnson inside of K-State territory.
Holding, holding. Offense, number 70. 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
That's not Christian Jones.
Casey Thompson just has to get through his progression and get that ball out, that little pump fake, get that ball to, out to Roshan Johnson. He can make that defender miss. Elder there, but all for naught. Christian Jones tugged on somebody.
It looks like he and Felix and UDK Uzama, they were talking to one another about how to get past without a penalty there, possibly. Tell them exactly what he did to one another. It's a second and 13.
A lot of guys in this league trying to figure out how to block that guy.
The best pass rushers in the country. And Thompson checks it down, gives to Jared Wiley. Wiley pushed out of bounds by Elder. Good gain there for the tight end. Just the eighth catch of the season for Jared Wiley. Picks up 20.
How do you deal with the pass rusher? You screen him. You don't even try to block it. Run, work that inside charge, run to Casey Thompson, and slip it in behind him to Wiley. And a great job downfield. Christian Jones leading the way here along with Majors.
Wiley 6'7", 250 rumbling down the field for a first down. Like a wildcat again with Johnson. Roshan Johnson keeps, has a hole. Makes the first man miss before being dropped by Julius Brents. Good gain there from Roshan Johnson, who has become the lead back this season with the injury to Bijan Robinson. It's a pickup of 7.
A couple of these schemes with the polar and a kicking out tight end. They're doing a nice job. Coach Sarkisian doing a nice job of doing that from different ways. And then obviously with the quarterback issues, Hudson Card, Casey Thompson. As runners, a lot of them turn into wildcat.
Bijan, you saw there on the sideline, the dislocated elbow. Roshan Johnson, last year, career best 139 yards against Kent State, plus 3 touchdowns. He's able to move the pile forward for a first down. And as Jared Wiley lets us know.
And nothing fancy about this. This is just 6'2", 219 from Port Neches Groves. Watching this. After a little token fake, I got this. Get him behind my big polo, Hayden Connor, and get physical.
Sets up first and 10 at the 30. Thompson with time. Once again back to Wiley. Wiley makes the first man miss and delivers a shot. Picks up 5. Fourth out of bounds by Echo Boydo. So a couple of receptions on this drive for Wiley. His first 2 catches of the game.
Yeah, showing his elusiveness, did a great job getting vertical on that screen, and then right there makes one of their best players, best tacklers, Reggie Stubblefield, miss in space. And Casey Thompson, again, lined up out wide.
Roshan Johnson in the wildcat with Keelan Robinson off his left hip. Second and 5, Johnson keeps. It'll spin forward, set up third down.
Roshan Johnson did a great job of moving Keelan Robinson around. You can see he has a great feel for this. Playing quarterback.
Johnson now over 100 yards for the day. A pickup of 3. 11th play of the drive coming.
He's like, Coach, man, I got us in the 3rd and 2. I got to come out.
Texas 7 of 11 on 3rd down today. They've often been in 3rd and 4. Give to Keelan Robinson. He gets tripped up. Jalen Pickle was right there. And in the second half, K-State has been stout on 3rd down.
Between Timmy Horn, 98, Jalen Pickle, 93. He got about 640 pounds. After Thanksgiving, probably more like 650. Getting in the backfield, creating a pile. 4th down. Defensive coordinator Joe Kleinerman, they're happy about that stop.
39-yarder for Cameron Dicker. And the senior is able to split the uprights and put the Longhorns in front. Texas now a two-point lead as Dicker is good from 39 yards out. And Texas leading with just under two to play in the third quarter. Welcome back to Fox College Football, sponsored by AT&T Business.
That is awesome. Fired up to go home and get some more leftover pie.
Get the turkey sandwich carved up and ready to go. There is leftover pie in your house? That's impressive. Or there are just so many pies. That's the problem.
plethora of pies.
So Cameron Dicker's had a pretty eventful day. He has knocked through two field goals. He's made two special team tackles. Unfortunately,
don't worry about the extra point. Come on.
We'll gloss over that. It keeps dangerous. Knowles on the return, taking a knee. Well, Deuce Vaughn from nearby Round Rock, Texas, mentioned earlier, is dad, a former assistant for the Longhorns, now a scout for the Cowboys. And you can see what growing up in Texas as a football player would mean to any young man, but especially one whose family has such ties to the game. Deuce Vaughn, this game means a lot to him, more than the usual game, because of his affiliation with the state of Texas and his dad's ties to the program, as they go Wildcat here with Deuce. Plenty of tickets requested by number 22 for this one. Almost trips himself up, brought down by Schooler after Vaughn falls forward for five.
That's one of the hardest things for these Wildcat quarterbacks is rhythm, the timing of how the blocks happen. You know, you normally right there is getting the ball from the quarterback and there's footwork involved, and what you do with that action right there, you almost fell down. But that's the hardest part, is just that little token timing to get everybody else deployed on the right timing.
Vaughn 4 yards shy of what would be his fifth consecutive 100-yard game. They motion Phillip Brooks. Back to Vaughn, puts his foot on the ground and turns up field to set up third and very manageable. And Vaughn lost a shoe. His cut was so good.
That's a way to get him out of the game. Rip it out. Watch 46 here. Redirect. Come back in. He's upfield. He comes back. Ray Thornton finishes the tackle.
Remember, there's no Joe Urban for K-State today. Their change of pace back. He's unavailable. Did not make the trip. Jacardia Wright has taken the field. He's not been used much this year as they try to get that shoe back on Vaughn.
Might be the new strategy to stop him right there.
Third and two. Howard swings it out to Phillip Brooks, who is brought for a loss right away. Ovi Agufu, the Notre Dame transfer, snips it out on third down.
It's just all predetermined. There's no read. There is a quarterback run involved in this, and I'm surprised they're not forcing Will Howard to get back to that. When you have to press on that slot receiver, allowing it that close to Landry Weber, it's easy for him to beat on that long of a throw.
Yeah, Agofu covered two men there. That's the other. Now Jamison back for the return, which will happen when we start the fourth quarter. We got a good one today. 19-17. Texas in front. Now the great Vince Young, College Football Hall of Famer, is number 10, retired by the Longhorns. That great Rose Bowl, BCS National Championship over USC. A game-winning run with under 20 seconds to play. And, you know, it's a big game when number 10 is on the sidelines. Vince Young down there for Texas as we go to the fourth quarter. Texas leading by two. State to punt. Takes a Wildcats roll to about 20. Pacific Life game summary sponsored by Pacific Life. More than 150 years strong. Protect what matters most. Casey Thompson on the afternoon is thrown for 149 yards, and this touchdown, it was a sensational catch by Kate Brewer. The always reliable Cameron Dicker with a missed PAT and a 71-yard touchdown run by Will Howard getting the start today with the injured Skylar Thompson. And then how about the leg of the true freshman, Chris Tennant, who poked it through from a career-long 51 yards today for the Wildcats. Out of the pistol. A hand to Johnson.
Both offenses will certainly have something to say about this, but Texas fans, man, sure hoping that first ever missed extra point by Cameron Dicker doesn't come back to haunt him.
Look at the fourth quarter point differential and the Big 12 ranks this year. Nobody's been better in the Big 12 than K-State. They're plus 58. The fourth quarter woes have haunted Texas almost all season long. They're minus 31. They've had some epic fourth quarter meltdowns. They lead it by two to begin the fourth quarter. On the bootleg from Thompson, he puts on the brakes, fires a strike, and it's caught by Washington. Echo Boydo on the tackle, but a first down catch by Marcus Washington.
Good job pushing this vertical by Marcus Washington. Speedster right there, just getting Boydo out of his pedal, comfortable throwing catch.
It's good for 15 as Johnson is tripped up, shy of the 40.
He knows it right there, man. I think he's got a chance to go. That's like you catch a blade or catch a whatever on your skate. Had a chance right there, just went down.
Meanwhile, you think about this fourth quarter from the perspective of this Texas team and especially their seniors. This is senior day, final home game of the season, and more than likely this will be the final game of the year for Texas. Should they win and get the 5 wins, there is an outside chance for a bowl berth if there are not enough bowl qualifying teams at the end of the regular season. This is a Texas team trying to snap a 6-game losing streak in what has been a treacherous season for this entire program and the seniors in particular, as Nate Matlack came in and laid the lumber to Casey Thompson.
Matlack, again, just comes untouched. Miscommunication there, front side from Amane, and that leads to that shot on Casey Thompson. But no doubt about it, this means everything to these seniors. We saw Derek Kush celebrate together, a whole team. The starting offensive tackle brought the whole team together between quarters. This means everything to this team. It's a pride moment here for this program.
Third and long now for Thompson. Pressure coming. Thompson off his heels, and he finds Brewer. The tight end Brewer just shy of the 50 and shy of the first down. Echo Boydo with the tackle. He's been busy in the second half in particular. Pressure that time from Cody Fletcher.
Gosh, Cody Fletcher just stopped his feet. If he runs through this, there's no chance that Casey Thompson is going to make this throw, but he does, and it is a tremendous throw to Kay Brewer, and then a better tackle in space to eliminate the possibility of a conversion.
Fletcher, a native Texan. So Sark's offense can't convert on third and long, and Dicker is out to punt. Signaling for a fair catch just inside the 10. Long field ahead for K-State, trailing by 2. Early moments of the fourth quarter, and Boydo tackling Brewer, forcing the Longhorns to punt. Fox College Football is sponsored by Pacific Life, more than 150 years strong. Protect what matters most. Some of the old programs from the annual Thanksgiving weekend game between Texas and Texas A&M. That Thanksgiving weekend rivalry was spoiled once A&M left the SEC. And possibly
bring that back. Yeah, let's bring it back. Look, how great were those? Get the Egg Bowl, Texas, Texas A&M. Got to bring it back on Thanksgiving. Huge drive here for both teams. Obviously, see if Will Howard gets involved in the read game at all. And again, Deuce Vaughn, a heavy dose come out.
Vaughn has run for 100 yards today. They give it to Vaughn right away on first down. He gets hit hard. Chris Adamora. It's a 100-yard day for Vaughn. It's his fifth consecutive 100-yard rushing performance. And in terms of defensive efforts, Texas now 8 straight games allowing a 100-yard rusher. And look at these ranks since 2000. They've tied for the longest streak in the Big 12 of allowing a 100-yard rusher. TCU had one earlier this year that was eventually snapped. Back to Vaughn. Turns up field. Vaughn somehow cleared what would have been a vicious tackle. David Benda was flying in there, and Vaughn picks up the first down.
Yeah, very rarely need a clean shot on this guy. Maybe watching Emmitt Smith growing up in Dallas. Another deuce, but you see him getting skinny, but also being powerful, square, avoiding the collision. Watch 34 Ben Sinnott. Somebody for Jack Stineen has done a great job in that same play.
And that number one for Texas, Chris Adamora, he came flying in thinking he had a big hit. Howard looks like almost a dangerous pull that time from Howard. Almost lost the ball, but he keeps it and picks up four.
That's the read game. That's what we're coming back to. Similar to what he had for the touchdown run. The mesh is on the backside this time. Pulling it. Good job getting vertical, staying in bounds. Second and six. He was actually looking on the incorrect side of that read. Making sure he had some green grass.
He picks up four. Will they continue to pound the ground game? Yes, they will. He gives to Vaughn, who falls forward. Maybe Benda knocks him forward by a yard or so. It's been ground and pound for K-State on this drive.
Nice job with the backside cutoff here in the backside. Look at that. All that space for him to cut back into, and it's Benda or nothing to get him to the ground. Third and one.
Those are the football at the 30. Third down has been a struggle today for Chris Kleiman's crew. They're 1 of 7 on third down. Ben Sinnott in at the fullback. They hand the Vaughn out of the eye, and Vaughn is able to lunge forward enough to get the first down. Now Sinnott, 6'4", 245, battering ram.
Respot this. I think it's going to be fourth down. Yeah, they moved it back a little bit. Sinnott does a great job leading through there. Deuce cuts it back, and it looks like they're spotting that a little bit short, but it's definitely not a first down yet.
Oh, you're right. Fourth and short. Fourth and probably less than a yard.
On their own 30.
A big snap coming here.
Alert hard count.
Vaughn in the wildcat. Vaughn is wrapped up. Moral Ojomo on the tackle. Where will they mark him?
Gosh, it looked like he had him stopped, and he kind of wrapped him, threw him forward, but it has to get all the way to that tick on the 31. They're going to measure. Oh. The nose of that ball has to get, as you see the spot up there, if the down marker is right on that tick of the 31. Hard count is impossible. You're in the Wildcats, so you eliminate that possibility, but it's just a matter right there at the end how much they helicoptered it forward. Watch for any body part other than a foot, hand, wrist, anything else is down. He's up. Down. It's like it's just short to me.
And that is exactly the case. Texas sideline erupts. And Moro Ojomo, the big stop.
Put some life in this crowd. Put some life in every Longhorn fan around the world. Chris Kleiman rolling the dice there a little bit, but hey, that's a great call. Right in this situation, give it to your dude. You anticipate him being able to get a half yard and a better snap by this berated, downtrodden, beaten Texas defense.
Well, now all of a sudden, Texas in striking distance.
You're already in Dicker range. Don't want to think about that right now, but
31, Texas takes over. Roshon Johnson, gaping hole. Johnson with a stiff run inside the 10. Texas with all the momentum now.
Roshon Johnson, this little outside zone with the backside cut off that time from Wiley, and cannot and will not be denied right here. First and goal, Texas.
It's a gain of 21. Johnson last year had the career high 139-yard game against K-State. Today he's got 127 on the ground. Johnson again turns that field. L shoulder gets knocked down. He took a hit as opposed to giving a hit. Julius Brents in on the tackle as well, but Elder took a shot.
Yeah, he's still down. And exactly as you said, he was the hit-e. Instead of being the hitter, Roschon Johnson running like a man possessed.
Elder had some big hits last week in the home loss to Baylor. He had a career-high 10 tackles.
Johnson, again, is not small. That's 219, Elder 192. Hammer meets nail right there.
Elder, the senior out of Kansas City, being tended to, will step aside. See number 19 in white, Ross Elder, up on his feet and on the sideline after really taking a shot, trying to make a tackle on Roschon Johnson.
Yeah, just kind of got mid-air there, and Roschon Johnson, the lower man at nearly 220, just a physical mismatch there for Elder, who's a stud.
Second and goal. On play action, looking for Xavier Worthy, and it's batted by Russ Yeast. Poor throw.
Yeah, this is the other thing you're telling Casey Thompson. Hey, man, we've got three in our pocket. Take care of the rock. You see, Yeast, Russ Yeast, undercut it. He anticipates the throw flatter to the sideline, and Casey Thompson misses inside, bringing the pick back in play. Dodge one.
Third and goal from the six. In motion, Washington. Roschon Johnson trying to find a hole. Bounces off one man inside the five. Timmy Horn, the Charlotte transfer, has had such an impactful season for K-State, helping to make the stop and set up fourth and goal.
Yeah, watch big 98 inside, right over the nose. Just does a great job getting rid of his blocker and then holding on for dear life on Roschon Johnson.
There is Cameron Dicker looking for his third make on the afternoon. This is his shortest attempt. 22 yards out. And Dicker is good. They get 3 points out of it. It was this Steve Sarkisian defense that leads us to our celebration moment, sponsored by Allstate, who's going to be celebrating today. It was the Longhorns defense that stopped Deuce Vaughn on fourth and short. And then with the short field, Texas won at six. They settle for three. Dicker good from 22 yards out. Longhorns extend the lead. Fox College football is sponsored by AT&T Business. Well, the six-game losing streak has felt more like 6 years in Austin. They are leading 22-17 in the fourth quarter. They are trying to exercise the fourth quarter demons this year. Dicker good for the third time today. Trying to keep it away from Nick Knowles, dangerous kick returner. They go short. Phil Brooks is normally on punt return. Brooks makes a man miss and gets it out to the 40 for K-State. Good field position for K-State as we have an official down. Being helped up by the Texas sideline. Looks like he says he's all right. It's good to see. Like he got his legs taken out from him at the end here.
Oh! That's hard. Not seeing that one out of the corner of his eye. Ugh. Good to see him bounce up. Those guys, they do not have protection. That hurts on both ends, the knee and whatever you land on. Good to see him up.
Well, K-State's got to figure out something offensively. They've had nothing going in the second half. 38 total yards since halftime. And Will Howard getting the start today because Skylar Thompson is unavailable with an ankle injury. He's 1 for 3 since halftime for -2 passing yards. To the air, wide open, Malik Knowles. That's a good gainer on first down to move the chains. Make that Tyrone Howell, beg your pardon, Howell, the JUCO transfer, his first catch today.
This is the most comfortable that Will Howard has looked throwing the ball today. Good timing. Brooks draws the coverage. And 86 slips in there for his first catch of the year.
And they really like Howell's ball skills. On a JUCO national title before coming to Manhattan. He's fine. Finding the edge. Gets past school. Vaughn, a first down run. And another big gainer on first down for K-State as Vaughn's got a little swagger to him. He's well over 100 yards today.
Get the puller. You get Sinnott there as the lead blocker. And now it's Deuce on Schooler there in space. That is a tough matchup. You see him turn the corner square with power to get a little bit more.
Vaughn good for 20. Last year he ran for 125 against the Longhorns. Today 137.
Just on the knocking the door on the red zone here again. Paramount for Will Howard. Take care of the rock. Third back in the backfield with him, probably quarterback run.
That's been sent it to his left. That's exactly what happens. Picks up a few on first down. K-State looking for answers offensively with under 6 minutes to play. They have thrown, the Wildcats have, for 44 yards today. That's it.
Well, Howard looking a little top heavy there against 6'4", 235. Has to use that to his advantage.
Here's the biggest play of the day, the 71-yard touchdown run. K-State's run for over 220 yards. Back to Vaughn. Vaughn cuts upfield. So slippery. Another good run from Deuce Vaughn. Jaron Thompson, who's moved to a starting role this year for Texas, finally brings him down.
Nice execution again. Good cut by Deuce getting vertical. But this is the threat of Will Howard that opens up this big old cutback lane. Watch that space just expand. They know they have to account for him. And now Deuce makes that man miss. Ojimo in space.
Whole line substitutions here for Texas on defense. Third and one. They're geared up for 22. The Wildcat snap. Vaughn. And he is met immediately and stuffed. This Longhorns defense in the second half. This time Devin Richardson. A thinned out linebacker core, and Richardson able to step up.
Yeah, same scheme, but just blown up inside. And again, that time it was Coburn that set the line of scrimmage back just a little bit. They ran the same play as they did on that previous fourth and inches, and they're going to get another choice to make here.
Remember, Texas without their top two linebackers, top two leading tacklers, the Marvion Overshown, the senior, and Luke Brockermeyer.
Zero coverage, run-stopping defense right here.
Howard sets up the option. He keeps, and Howard falls forward. It looks like he's short. It's another fourth down stop by this Texas defense. Keandre Coburn, the big nose tackle, filling the space.
Great stop from Texas. They're trying to run the speed option up top. They should be running it this way. We'll talk about that when we come back. But a huge fourth down stop for Texas.
Massive stop by the Longhorns. We're winning the fourth quarter today. Fox College Football is sponsored by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And by Wendy's, official breakfast of NCAA football. Now this Longhorns team playing some inspired defense. Back to the fourth down stop.
This is a speed option play. This is why you always check this play. Look over here. They're playing zero blitz. There's nobody on the back end. Here's the best way to go. Here's the best way to go get that one-on-one matchup out there. You pitch off that guy. Instead, they need to make about 14 blocks. Credit Texas, but K-State can help themselves by getting in the best look.
Direction after Roshan Johnson, and the pile moves him forward a few more yards. Under 4 minutes to play now. Both teams with a full allotment of timeouts. K-State using their first.
30 seconds.
Very difficult. difficult first season, especially the back half of it for Steve Sarkisian. Longest active losing streaks among Power 5 schools. Texas trailing only Duke and Indiana. They've lost six in a row. Longest losing streak for the Longhorns since 1956. And with a loss today, would have lost seven straight going into the offseason unless they could come up with a bowl berth because of not enough bowl qualifying teams. So for Sark and company, my goodness, to get a win today on Senior Day, final home game against a 7-win K-State team would be enormous. They go Wildcat with Johnson once again. He empties out Robinson. Johnson tripped up and accepts up third down. And timeout coming again.
We'll take another quick timeout. But a ton of credit in this whole thing has to go to Roshan Johnson. Obviously, the opportunities, this is his 26th attempt today in the absence of Bijan Robinson, but whatever he had, he needs to just eat Thanksgiving before every game and go out and just do his thing.
Well, he is our game MVP, sponsored by Indeed. To hire your small business MVP, you need Indeed. He entered today with 139 yards is his career high. That came last year against the Wildcats. Today, he's rushed for 136.
He is knocking on the door, but just running again like a man possessed. He's that angle cutter right there. He gets going vertical. One, two, three, four tacklers to get him to the ground. Unbelievable effort and performance today from Roshan. Doing a bunch of stuff mentally. You see him moving guys around as a quarterback, showing his skills and his head.
Big game last year against the Wildcats, and another big one today. 36 now, we'll bring Thompson back in at quarterback. Emotions worthy, who's had a fairly quiet second half. Must have been banged up. Back to Johnson. Johnson bulldozes his way forward for a first down. He is just running over tacklers. TJ Smith has been a speed bump. And another half dozen on this K-State defense. It's a career high now for Roshan Johnson. He's run for 153 yards today.
I don't think I've ever seen nine guys tackle somebody, but that just happened. They went rugby scrum at the end of this. Two, three, four, five, six defenders. Cody Fletcher says, I better get in here. Rossi says, I better get in here. The whole team can't get him to the ground.
And number seven in white, TJ Smith, he's a violent tackler. And he went along for the ride.
It's such a big, big conversion right there. K-State using those two timeouts. They now only have one left, three and counting.
3 minutes to play. Johnson adding on to his big day. He's inside Wildcat territory, inside the 40 before laying a hit to Russ East. And Roshan Johnson has been the star. Another 24 yards. He's run for 177 on the day.
You just don't see teams do this against K-State. A little split zone as Kate Brewer comes to the backside and cuts off the backside defender. Roshan Johnson does the rest.
K-State entered today 21st in the nation, allowing just 119 yards per game on the ground.
Good job protecting the ball on the end of that as that gets in highlight yellow, career high.
So those two top rushing performances coming at the expense of K-State. This time they hand it off to Keelan Robinson, who is dropped in the backfield by Cody Fletcher.
Fletcher here, 55, shooting everything here. Daniel Green forcing it back to his partner. And K-State will take their final timeout.
Well, the second half has seen two tremendous fourth down stands by this Texas defense. And you add to that what Roshan Johnson has done, especially in the second half, although he had a very good first half as well. But some money runs by Johnson. And this is the type of spirit you'd have to think that Texas has been lacking on both sides of the ball for weeks at this point.
Absolutely. Credit that man. Credit Derek Kerstetter for rallying these guys together for this fourth quarter push. Roshan Johnson, unbelievable. The Texas faithful still wants to see him bring this home with 207. K-State without a timeout, but no doubt it's been the Texas defense that has stood tall against like themselves, a shorthanded K-State offense. Who have done a tremendous job in the second half, in particular the fourth quarter.
This Texas defense on the season has been exposed, to say the least, averaging 32 points allowed per game and almost 440 yards total offense. But today they have generally stifled this K-State offense, especially in the second half. K-State has gotten nothing going by and large since halftime. Second and long. Smith takes a hit by Johnson. Third and long now. Well, we take you back to those fourth down stops. Deuce Vaughn, one of the country's best running backs, gets beaten up. And then they try to set up the option, and Will Howard needed just a yard. Both times on fourth and short, this Texas D-line has been up to the task.
So Texas will work this all the way down here. Play clock.
And there are 8 seconds to play. They go wild count for Johnson. Johnson drags a tackler, set up fourth down.
Down K-State, no timeouts. That's the hardest part about working all this Wildcat stuff, but they'll take it. Is Roshon Johnson didn't milk every second off that. It's just hard for a guy to work those mechanics, but they'll take their chances here. Fourth and 12. It'll be almost 30 seconds by the time if K-State gets the ball back.
Well, K-State has been shut out in the second half.
12 yards passing, no points.
They are without their six-year senior quarterback, Skylar Thompson. Injured his ankle late last week in a loss to Baylor. Texas takes their first timeout. 40 seconds to play. Texas seconds away from snapping a six-game losing streak on Senior Day. Under 40 seconds to play to the back of the end zone. Well, K-State, 33 seconds remaining. They're averaging fewer than 4 yards per play in the second half. They've gained just 81 yards of total offense.
12 through the air, but hey, and no timeouts, Will Howard. And 33 seconds and a lively, fired-up Texas defense. See how they can respond. K-State that time brought 11, had no returner back there. Texas did a nice job, just the mechanics of the protection. Snap kick, get it out, don't care about the yards.
33 seconds left, no timeouts. They start on the 20.
You can see Texas protecting the sideline smartly.
Howard throwing on the run. First down reception, Sammy Wheeler. K-State hustling. That's a pick of a 13.
Texas here defending the sideline. Here, letting do anything they want inbounds.
Changing directions, checking down to Deuce Vaughn. Vaughn can't get out of bounds. Darian Dunn tracks him down.
Got to hustle the clock it.
Under 10 seconds. Howard.
Got to play now. Under 2 seconds. The referee blew the play dead. The white hat blew the play dead. They're talking about...
Sark and the Longhorns are headed towards midfield. And so much for the play being blown dead. All zeros on the scoreboard with the time, and Texas snaps the six-game losing streak. Not that K-State maybe had a chance there, or a good chance, but you saw something different?
Right. Well, no, it was under 3 seconds, so you can't spike it. You got to run a play, but it looked like he prematurely blew that play dead. It'd be interesting to take a look, but I mean, tough uphill battle. Texas, a tremendous response in the second half here defensively. It looked to me like the white hat blew the play dead, like he wanted to talk to the center judge or the umpire that was placing the ball.
What is Steve Sarkisian feeling right now?
Well, I was a little relieved. There's certainly going to be some joy, some thankfulness here at this time of year. But got a lot of work to do, right? A ton of work to do. Big smile on his face there as he celebrates. That's Imator Bebe, who's been involved with Sark in the past from a recruiting standpoint, being the Imator Bebe. But just a ton of work to do. They got to get better personnel-wise. There'll be some, obviously, involved in a bunch of recruits like they always have been at Texas. Have to close on those guys. Have to improve at quarterback. and then a lot of other stuff to do.
Well, we just saw Brendan Schooler there, one of the 29 seniors for Texas, and their final home game in a Texas uniform. Texas snaps the six-game losing streak, and they beat a good K-State team, a bowl-bound Wildcat squad. K-State's now lost two straight, losing last week at home to a ranked Baylor team. K-State 7-5, Texas 5-7. And for Sark, what has been just a pressure cooker of a first year at Texas. He has dealt with everything on the field, off the field, and if there's anything in between, he's dealt with it. He said he's built for it, but even if you're wired and built for it, it doesn't make it easy. He's been through the ringer this year, and his Texas team takes down K-State 22-17.
Yeah, he told us that he thought there were about 10 plays from 9-2. I think that's definitely the glass half full approach coming into this game. But he knows the work that's ahead of him.
Just talking with Kate Brewer right there, one of the seniors for Texas. Had that tremendous touchdown catch, a very pivotal touchdown catch when you look at the final score in this one. 22-17, the six-game losing streak is no more as Texas takes down K-State. We'll have more college football coverage with Rob and the guys after this break. For Coach Mark Helfrich, I'm Aaron Goldsmith. Happy Thanksgiving.